ARD, it's one of the well-renowned stations within the world and within Australia. It used to be one of the biggest in the Southern Hemisphere. It's one of the oldest cattle stations. It's well over 100 years old. It's been owned by quite a few people. But today, VRD is quite small to what it used to be. It consists of about 9,000 square kilometres, which is 4 properties, VRD itself, and the 3 outstations, Mullaloo, Pigeon Isle, and Mount Sanford. When you work in the round yard, you must be very calm and relaxed. If you wave your arms around and jump, you'll make cattle very scared, and that will keep the cattle nice and quiet in the yard. If you jump and wave around and make noise, they will get frightened, very frightened. And just relax on your gate and let them walk out, yeah, and have faith in what your judgment.
Mustering may be done on foot with various vehicles, horses, or with aircraft. Techniques in mustering cattle will depend on region, culture, distance, and the type of terrain involved. Whereas cattle mustering lends itself more toward the use of horses, the most popular horse for this job would be a stock horses. And people who muster cattle are usually called stockmen. Understanding cattle behavior is the basic of efficient and safe, especially when mustering.
Hakebury is very dedicated to keeping the Indonesian program up and going. We see it a great thing of building relationships between two countries, between Indonesia and Australia, building strengths to keep our live export market up and going, as well as educating our staff and the students about the two different cultures and where our cattle go and some of the things they are looking to for. I think it's a great educational thing for both sides, Australians and the Indonesian students.
CBC, Kidda Better, Kidda Ungrew.